Welcome back to my studio, and a huge hello if it's your first time here. I'm Becky. Today we're building a circuit to measure the precise angle of a knife blade while it's being sharpened. This is a collaboration with one of my favorite YouTubers, Alex French Guy Cooking, who's always making and sharing inspiration around food.
Hey guys, what's up, it's Alex.
When Alex first approached me with this idea, my first thought was to try using an accelerometer to detect the angle. So I pulled out my Circuit Playground board, which not only has a List 3DH accelerometer, but also some LEDs I could use to create a crude feedback interface for the preferred angle. I taped a magnet to the back, kept it plugged in over USB, and then stuck it to the side of the blade. For a 10-minute prototype, it actually worked okay. But practically speaking, there's a problem with precision here, since during the actual sharpening, the knife blade is moving from side to side on a different axis than we're trying to measure, which throws off the reading. The proper term for what we're trying to measure is dead reckoning, or absolute orientation, and it requires a combination of many sensors to achieve, as well as processing power and sophisticated code to make any sense of the data in real time. The BNO055 does all that with an internal accelerometer, magnetometer, and gyroscope, as well as an ARM Cortex M0 processor that's doing all the sensor fusion and sending out values you can actually use, even if you don't have a PhD in sensor modeling. The fancy math it does is what makes it different than most other 9 DOF sensors you can find, and it makes it a bit pricier too. But this is one case where I'm willing to pony up in order to avoid writing my own Kalman filter. Knowing Alex was interested in using a mobile device for feedback and potential further development of this project, I hooked up the sensor to a small Bluetooth microcontroller board, the Adafruit Feather Bluefruit 32U4. I used the sensor library's sample Arduino code to test out the angle reporting over the serial monitor, and then set about soldering together a smaller version for attaching to the knife blade. To keep the sensor parallel to the blade, I mounted it on the underside of the microcontroller board and used thick neodymium magnets as standoffs. Add a little tape and a small battery, and this prototype is ready to rock. I used the Bluefruit LE Connect app for Android or iOS to receive the UART data from the microcontroller. The code I wrote, which is barely modified from the sample, prints the relevant knife angle out on the mobile device. Cool. The last feature to address before we can really get sharpening is that of waterproofing. The enclosure should be splash resistant since the blade is rinsed often while sharpening. The quickest thing to do is to stick the circuit in a plastic bag or two. It doesn't have to be pretty. Just to earn that extra gold star, I made a simple translucent 3D printed enclosure using Tinkercad. It has an O-ring on the lid to keep the water out. When it's dry, you can take out the stopper and charge the battery over USB. Oh, and I know somebody's gonna grill me about 3D printing waterproof enclosures, how you should use something that can be chemically smooth like ABS or something super high precision like nylon to make sure there's no holes. But for me and this pretty tame application, it worked just fine at 100% infill in regular PLA. But I linked a resource on that for y'all to check out below. So I got the stone Alex recommended in his first sharpening video, and I'm gonna give this a try. The idea here is to create something that helps you learn the muscle memory of sharpening, so you actually get better at it over time. Imagine that, an electronics device that is training itself out of usefulness. To develop the app side of this further, I would take a look at something called Cordova, which makes it easy to build your own app using HTML and JavaScript, as I've seen Todd Treese do with his very similar project for coaching your hand sawing angle. If you'd rather skip Bluetooth altogether, a simpler board could provide visual feedback using an LED or two, like a regular Feather 32U4. Thank you so much for watching. If you came here from Alex's channel, welcome. I've created a special playlist of my videos that I think you would also enjoy. The link to that and the full step-by-step tutorial for this build on Instructables are in the description below. Please give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I release new videos just about every week about technology, crafts, and my life here in New York City. See you next time.